Okay, welcome back to part two of making my little shelving nook. And we've got this so far. So what I've gone ahead and done is cut out, I've measured and cut out the papers, decorative papers I need. So I've measured there, and I'll need 3 7/8. Do your own measuring for yours, okay? And that is a 4 inch, and then this is 3 1/2, so that would be 3 1/2. This is 3 5/8. That's a 3 inch one. So I've measured each individual piece. Now, obviously, the 12-inch sheets of paper are not going to fit across, so we have to use another cut-off piece. I've already gone and put tape around them. Now, if I can remember, I think that's a 4-inch one. Yep, so 4-inch. That one goes on here. I'm just going to tape the backing tape off of this short bit. Oops. Help if I took the lid off. Some glue in there. Got a little bit of an overhang, so I'll move that. Tuck that in. And the other one is the same. I've got the tape down each long side, plus one in the middle. And we'll just cover it with some glue. And start from that end, right up to the corner, right, corner. See that one? There we go. So now we're going to put the middle one on, which is not that one, I don't think. Yes, it is. Spread on the glue. Refill soon, I think. Mm. been terribly fussy with what papers I use or which way designs go. Basically using up paper I don't like. That's what you can do with a project like this for yourself. Use up all your scraps. First shelf done. Second one is this one, I think. Can't remember which one it is. This one is slightly bigger. So that goes on the base. That is, my measurement is 3 5/8. Oops, base. Always give it a quick burnish to spread that glue around. This one. to put the glue on. These three rows of tape is good enough. But I just like that extra security just for myself. Take long if you've done all the prep work first. Got some overhangs. Two shelves done. There we go for the last one, and we'll just turn it upside down for a sec. The bottom is 3 inches, so it's not that one. It's this pretty flowery one. Thank you. piece. Now, let's put some dividers in. Inside here. I've got the light behind me, it's not good. Okay, that. Now you want them nice and firm. So that one is going to be pretty much exactly 4 inches or just a tad under. So make it. I'll make mine 3 15/16. Okay, so I'm just going to make a note. 3 15/16 by 1 2 3 3/4. It should be the same size as, yeah, 3 3/4. We've still got our what do you call them? Our hinges. There's plenty there, probably more than I need. Right. Three and 5/16 by 3 3/4. So we've got 7.5. So let's go the 3 3/4. I'm trying to make good use of this. If it doesn't work, doesn't work. Not to worry. 3 3/4 high. By 3 5/16. Now look, the same size. Okay, let's try it. See how it fits. No, it's too short by a quarter of an inch. So that measurement should have been, wow, 4 inches. They'll come in handy. As long as I don't make too many mistakes. Okay, 4 inches. That's a nice fit, that there. So that is 3 3/4. Beautiful. One of the, on earth is happening here. Sorry. Okay, one of your hinges that's got the 1/4 inch scored lines in the center. You'll want one of them. Ouch, paper cut. We're going the right way. There's a little mark there. And we'll cut that. On the inside of this, you put some tape on one side, then the opposite side. And then the glue again. Making sure we put this in the right side so it goes up there. Okay, so we'll do the second one as well. Oops. Don't really like tearing it. Okay, whoops, fit that quarter inch over first. Can be a little bit tricky. Paper on them. Look, that's almost a perfect fit. And this I'm just going straight with the glue. Use the tape if you want. You're just using the glue. Have a good burnish. Really, really good burnish. Make sure you put your glue right on the edge as well, and the corners. Needed a bit of a trim. Okay, we'll put one in. Good. So now what we're going to do is, let me just fix this light. Okay, we're going to put this glue on all three sides, across the bottom, okay, and then we're just going to slide it in where we want it. There, make sure it is straight. Okay, now we've got our first little cubby hole. Yep, I do think my blade is blunt. Possibly on both knives. Oops. Plenty of room. Plenty of border around the paper. I don't want it right up to the edge. So as you can see here, I've got plenty of border around there. And let's cut this one to match. If you prefer to cover the whole thing, that's your choice, you can do that. Decide where we want it and how wide we want it. Now spaces. Okay, I'm going to pop this where that division line is, so I'm going to cover that. Make sure it's straight. Oops, as crooked as we can be. Whoops. Okay, now you can add another one here if you want, but I'm going to leave that nice big space there. Now we measure this one. From inside to inside, we've got 3 5/8. Okay, 3 5/8. Just right. going to do it just a little bit. It seems a little loose, this one. So we'll go a little bit more than 3 5/8. 1 2 3 5/8. I don't think I need as much as a 4/8, so I'm going to take a 1/16. And that should do it. See why I can't give you precise measurements to start with? You have to do your own. Now that's better. They've got to go in and be able to stand up. That's the only thing holding them together. When you get there, is the glue. So how tall do I want them? Same as them. There. Okay, fold in that hinge on that 1/4 inch center. Measure it for here. Grab our top. Oops. I needed just a little bit of a trim. can be a bit more precise than I am and measure everything. Ease it open and then push it together. You can put pins in there to help hold it down. I'll just put the pin in that one and that one. This is just a little crooked. Okay, we decide where we want this. I think so, right in the middle of that one. Maybe a little bit to that side. So I'm going to put another one here. So back to the glue. Looks pretty straight. Stick that pin in there. If you look this over. Okay, so we want another one that measurement. What were these? Piece of this. A little bit better, I think. Okay. Remove the backing tape. Fold in any straggly bits. Thank you. let's see how that's going to fit. Do that on the exact place. You could probably fast forward all this. I'm not sure how to do it myself. Okay, I like that one. Now for the last one. See what we measure. Obviously the same height. Just 3 and can't see it very well. 3 3/4, 3 7/8, no, 5/8. High. This measurement is 3 3/1/8, I think. Okay, 3 1/8. 3 1/8. Did I say? I can't remember. 3 7/8, I think. No, 3 5/8. Inside that one. Okay. Not sure how many to put in there. 2 maybe there. Yep. Put 2 in. Oops. So again, we've got our hinge. Bear in mind that foam board is very, very light, very lightweight, and for this design, we are only having the two main shelves. But if you wanted yours to go that way, so that these were your shelves, you would have to secure them with pins or brads through there. And this is not meant for heavy stuff. We're nearly finished. Then we're going to put some pretty paper around the outside, which is probably the easiest job of the lot. Overhang there and fix that. Okay, let's decorate now. When I do my lazy measurements like this, I'll put this down and I'll make sure I've got an eighth of an inch overhang here on the bottom and an eighth of an inch overhang at this side. And when I cut, that will give me a sixteenth of an inch on each side. Thereabouts. See? Just enough for a little gap around it. Thank you. I say I was going to put? I think right in the middle. Pins. Put as many of these divisions as you like, depending on the size of what you're planning to keep on your shelves. There, I think. Oops, we're upside down. Use a good glue for this. Pins out, they'll be a bit sticky, so just give them a wash with a baby wipe or something. Oops. Right. That's it so far. How cool is that? It's beautiful. now we're going to wrap around. And we're going to do it from this measurement, which is, we're going to go four inches. Chosen this wood grain. First up, we'll take that selvage off. From memory, I need four pieces, I think. Two. Well, I've got six pieces. I'm going to start by, let me just move my camera up a little bit so you can see what I'm doing. Okay. I'm going to start by putting it straight across there and just bending that first one. So we are going to put three strips. Backing, and again we are going to put a little bit of the glue on. Especially on the ends where there is no tape. Right. just a sec, I'll show you it on top of the first one I made. It up as best you can. Now you don't have to put anything on the bottom, but you can if you want. Oops. To do the bottom, there's no point in wasting paper. Overhang. Okay. That's it, that's perfect. Perfect. I can't remember which is top and which is bottom. I don't think it matters, really. I'm going to leave those inner pins on for now. Let's go and see. I wouldn't go any higher than 2 because it's very lightweight. But that's absolutely beautiful. I love it. So I'll put that up there again. There we go. All finished. Oops. Okay, that didn't take long at all. Easy peasy. I could make more to go alongside it. Along the side, maybe.
Okay.
They would also look work well in a cupboard. Okay. Thank you very much for joining me for this second half and final of this project, and I hope you give it a go. Okay, I'll see you in my next video, and please make a comment whether you like or not. Please make a comment, I'd love to hear from you, and subscribe if you want to see any more of my videos. Thank you very much. I'll see you later.